What influence has Detroit had on you as a budding entertainer, a star in the making?
A lot, because when we first started dancing when we were little, my grandma told us stories about Detroit, how Detroit used to bring in all the big entertainers and stars, and how they used to generate a lot of like fans, money, everything through Fox Theater. And then when we started dancing and getting real serious about it, like, we wanted to be a part of it. So Detroit, honestly, we started in Ypsilanti with talent shows, and then Detroit brought us in to the performances in Fox Theater. So that's the type of influences Detroit has done for us.
Now, when we talk about where you see yourself, because you're a young guy, and I remember, say, I'm old enough to remember when Michael Jackson was about your age, and when I first saw him, and he did a song called I Want You Back with the Jackson 5, there was an energy, there was something so great. So I'm talking to you now. Maybe I could be talking to Michael Jackson, but I was as young as he was at that time. But now I'm talking to you. So let me know, what is a dream yet to come true as an entertainer that you see in your young but promising life?
To be honest, it's crazy because I can get into places I never thought I would be in as I'm 16. So it's a good experience. It's great to see get grown people's attention on me because I'm young, and it's just great to have little fans of me. I'm like 12 years old, 16, and 21 and up, so it's a great experience.
So now, where do you see yourself when you're an old man of 21 years old?
21, I don't know, maybe, California.
Now, I'm looking at you, and it's funny because they were so young when they came out, but now they're older men, kid in play. So I'm seeing this sort of like channeling of kid in play. Is that a duel that means something to you? And have they had any influence on your style?
Yes. Before I got the locks in my head, I actually had a high top for 5 years. And everywhere me and my brother went, and everywhere we danced at, they always used to say, kid and play, kid and play. And earlier we had our pants backwards, and they kind of compare us to Crisscross.
Oh, to Crisscross, yeah.
Yeah, Crisscross. Do they rock several weeders? The back down of the gear. A daddy
back on the gear. Crisscross on the gear. Okay, now as dancers, and I know that, you know, there's so many different types of dancers, and you can study dancing, you can watch a video and pick up some moves. Where and how did you pick up your dancing abilities?
Okay. Our grandma started off with Prince and Michael Jackson, because my grandma always said nobody used to dance like Prince, and then Michael Jackson was our main focus. And then we moved on to Chris Brown, and then Usher. And currently, the late twins. The late twins are our current like inspiration and in how we think of our moves and how we listen to the music, because when we listen to the music, we listen to every beat. They taught us musicality. Every beat, all the background drums, the horns, everything, we hear that when we dance. So when we dance, you might see our arm move, our body move a certain way to the music. So people be like, wow, I wish I can dance like them, or y'all should open dance lessons or anything.
Pulse of a new generation. Pulsebeat.tv.